Please don't ask me why I stood around and waited for this fool to like kill me or kidnap me, because I don't have the fucking answer. Hello, my beautiful people, and welcome back to my channel. I am hitting you guys today with a story time video, naturally. I'm just gonna go straight into the story time without wasting anybody's time. So let's go ahead and get started. So today's story time is gonna be about yet another bad online experience. So this guy, I'm not exactly sure how we started talking. I'm sure it was through one of those online dating sites. I just don't remember which one. So this guy, right off the bat, he only spoke Spanish. And I'm not very great in Spanish. I don't very fluently speak Spanish, but I do understand it and I do know how to speak it in the sense of like I can hold a conversation, but not like to the full extent, like I don't know everything. I was having a conversation with this guy in Spanish and it went a little something like this. He started off with asking me normal questions like, you know, where do you live? What's your age? You know, how tall are you? You know, things that you're trying to find out about each other. Let me just say, I was probably around the age of 17 years old or... No. I was probably like around 15, 16 years old when I first started talking to this guy. And I remember he was maybe around the ages, from what he told me, was around 18, 19 years old. So we were talking and it literally wasn't maybe even longer than, I want to say like 2 days. I was very naive. People, ladies, gentlemen out there, like, don't do what I do, don't do what I did. I mean, this is why these videos of mine exist, is to help everyone not make these mistakes, because this decision was literally an idiotic decision. 2 days with talking with this guy, we already planned to meet up, and I don't remember where he said he was coming from, but I gave him my address. Not the smartest idea, but I did. And so we planned to meet up and he said that he was gonna come see me. Mainly the time that I told him I was gonna be available was around the nighttime. Again, an idiotic mistake. You should never meet anyone at nighttime by yourself. If you're gonna go and meet someone online for the first time, it should be out in public. It should be probably during the day and it should be with somebody. I know there's a lot of like controversies out there saying like if you should bring somebody with you, like if you should bring another, let's say like girlfriend with you. It's controversial because they say that it could be a potential like cock block, right? But in this circumstance, if the guy is cool enough and he knows the world around him, and in this day and age with the way the world is, it should not be a problem. He should be understanding that, you know, it's only logical and it's only the safest thing for a girl to do when meeting a stranger. So anyway, again, carrying on our conversation in Spanish, I knew like surface details of him. I didn't know a lot. So skipping all the tiny little details of this story, let's get straight into the juiciness. The night came where we said that we were gonna meet up around, I think it was like around 8 o'clock. I said, meet me at this church. And the reason why I told him to meet me at a church at nighttime was because that was the only, I wanna say like more public area. I felt more safe than meeting at my actual like apartment. So he texts me saying, okay, I'll see you there. As the time got closer, he keeps telling me, okay, I'm on my way, I'm on my way. Y'all, when I tell you that this situation could have gone bad in 2 seconds, I am not lying. I'm telling you the decisions I made in this story is not even funny. How dumb I was. Naive, how naive I was in this situation. I literally could have been kidnapped and no one would have known why, because I did not even tell anybody that I was gonna meet this guy because I was too afraid what everyone was gonna say. Just another tip, you go see someone, you're meeting a stranger, carry some sort of something that you can use as a weapon with you. Carry a little like pocket knife thing, carry some mace. So I was waiting for him, and finally it hits the time where he said he was supposed to be here. He was also late, about 25-30 minutes late. Finally, he tells me, hey, I'm close, come outside. So I started getting anxious and all jittery and all that, you know, feeling. And so I started walking towards the church. I'm walking, and I text him. Once I arrived there, I said, hey, I'm outside. And for two, three minutes, I didn't get a text back. I was like waiting, I was looking around, you know, just kind of like being suspicious, kind of being just like aware of my surroundings, checking if anyone was gonna come up like right behind me. And finally he texts me back saying, okay, I'm here. And I was like, okay, well, where are you? I don't see you. He said, well, where are you? I was just like, well, I'm right here in front of the church. And he was just like, oh, okay, I think I'm behind the church. Let me go drive to the front. So I was like, okay, I'll wait here for you. About another like 2 minutes go by, 3 minutes go by, 4 minutes go by. I'm like, this church is not that big. Literally, this church is not that big. Like, it does not take no 5 minutes to drive around this church. It takes like 10 seconds to drive around the church to come to the front if you're in the back. Hello? Finally, I was like, hey, where are you? And he texts back literally maybe like 10 seconds after, saying like, well, I'm here, I've been waiting for you. I said, you didn't tell me that you were here. And he was just like, well, I'm in a red truck, I can see you. As soon as he said, I can see you, I was just like, that is the creepiest thing ever, because I can't see you and you're telling me you can see me. He said, I'm in a red truck, don't you see me? And I was looking around. There's no one parked in the parking lot area. There's no cars in the church. So if there was a red truck, I would have seen the red truck. So I was looking around and I was just like, where are you? As soon as I told him, I don't see you, where are you? He didn't text back like for a good 10 minutes. Please don't ask me why I stood around and waited for this fool to like show up somewhere and like kill me or kidnap me, because I don't have the fucking answer. I'm just as dumbfounded, lost as you are. I don't know what to tell you guys. He told me that he also had a gift for me. He said, come towards the red truck, I have a gift for you. I was like, hail to the mother loving no. I was just like, you know what, I gotta go home. I made up some BS excuse, like my dad, you know, he's gonna be home soon, and you know, he does business with the cops and all this stuff, so you know, he's gonna be back like any minute. And literally this guy went ghost on me, didn't text me back after that. And I started walking home with a very paranoid mind. I kept just like looking behind me, making sure no one was following me home or keeping an eye on me. I don't know what this guy's agenda was for me. All I know is that thank the good Lord, thank the heavens that someone was watching over me and was saying, girl, not today. Jesus was like, girl, not today, you ain't getting kidnapped today. So thank you, Jesus. But yeah, otherwise than that, guys, he didn't contact me after that, because I told him, look, you're crazy, you weren't there, I didn't see you, please don't ever contact me again or I will report you to the police. I told him I will report you. Mama don't play that shit. I deleted his number, blocked his number, and that was that. I don't know, like I said, I don't know what this guy had planned, but I don't wanna know, and it was freaking scary. So ladies and gentlemen, again, please learn from my mistakes. Make sure to just always be careful when meeting people online. I have plenty more stories I'm gonna tell you guys about my online experiences. Some of them are crazier than this. Get ready for those ones. But yeah, guys, so I hope you enjoyed the story time video. Sorry if it was like kind of like a little all over the place, but I was really trying to like get the facts straight because it was such a long time ago. But I was trying to remember everything in order. So I hope it came out good. If you're new to my channel, hello, my name is Mars. Welcome to my channel. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. If you like my content so far and my story times, and for all the non-new subscribers, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Please also give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. Little by little, I'm getting closer and closer to my dreams, and you guys are helping me along the way, and I so freaking adore you for that. Let me know if you guys have ever been through some crazy online shit. Leave them in the comments down below. I would love to know what you guys' experiences were. I am working on trying to make a diverse channel, meaning I'm trying to add different content in my channel. I'm doing story time videos and that's my love, like that's what I'm gonna be doing. But I'm gonna be adding little things here and there just to give it a pop of color in my channel. I'm gonna be doing another challenge and I'm thinking on doing them on Fridays. Mondays will be story times, Fridays will be challenges. Let me know what you guys think about that. I love you guys, take care out there, and I'll see you guys in my next story time video. Bye.